Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you to Naval Submarine Base, New London, and to the commissioning ceremony of USS Illinois. I'm Lieutenant Commander Preston Gilmore, the ship's executive officer. On behalf of the crew, I would like to extend our sincere thanks for joining us here today. Before our ceremony begins, I would ask you to please silence your cell phones for the duration of the ceremony. Thank you. We are here today to celebrate the commissioning of USS Illinois, the fourth ship to bear the name of our 21st state. The first Illinois was a screw sloop of war whose keel was laid in 1864 but was never completed. The second ship was the lead ship in the Illinois class of battleships, and she served our Navy from 1898 and proudly carried the Illinois name until 1941. The third Illinois would have been an Iowa class battleship, but her construction was canceled prior to laying keel in 1945. The ship moored before you, affectionately referred to as a boat by members of the submarine service, will soon join America's silent service. Illinois is the 13th submarine of the Virginia class. With its sister ships, it represents a revolution in submarine design, construction, and mission capability. Brimming with leading-edge technology and advanced engineering, this vessel brings versatility and firepower to the fleet. Illinois and the Virginia class are among the most effective platforms in the United States Navy, and this warship takes another step forward in advancing the superiority of our submarine force. Able to operate in the far corners of the world's oceans undetected while connected to air, sea, and land-based forces and key shore facilities, these submarines are equipped to wage multidimensional warfare around the globe. Illinois' adaptability makes it highly responsive to changing mission requirements and provides the nation with capabilities that range from auxiliary seawater, undersea warfare, anti-submarine warfare, and countermine warfare. Illinois will support surveillance, special operations, and covert strike missions. Thank you for allowing each of us the privilege to serve our nation as a part of your Navy while proudly bearing the name USS Illinois. Construction began on the submarine you see behind me in 2009, and it was christened on October 10th, 2015, here in Groton. Today, she is complete and battle ready. We are all very proud to serve on the newest attack submarine in the United States Navy. Today's ceremony is a time-honored tradition that began with the commissioning of the Navy's first ship, a captured British schooner, the Margaretta, in 1775. Since then, thousands of ships have undergone the transition from a silent hull to a fully alive warship. My shipmates, our commissioning crew, hereafter known as plank owners, are in formation and ready. Ship's company, a tin hut. Will the guests please rise and remain standing for honors, presentation of colors, our national anthem, and the invocation. Ladies and gentlemen, our platform guests, Lieutenant Guy Passmore, Chaplain Corps, United States Navy, our ceremonial chaplain. Captain Leonard Wass, United States Navy, retired. Chairman, USS Illinois Commissioning Committee. Captain Jeff Hayden, United States Navy, Supervisor of Shipbuilding, Groton, Connecticut. Captain John McGonigal, United States Navy, Commander, Submarine Squadron 4. Mr. Matthew Mulheron, President, Newport News Shipbuilding. Mr. Jeffrey Geiger, President, General Dynamics, Electric Boat. Rear Admiral Michael Jabley, United States Navy, Program Executive Officer, Submarines. Vice Admiral Joseph DeFalo, United States Navy, Commander, Submarine Forces. The Honorable Janine Davidson, Undersecretary of the Navy. Admiral Archie Clemens, United States Navy, retired. Admiral John Richardson, United States Navy, Chief of Naval Operations. The Honorable Joseph Courtney, United States Representative, 2nd District, State of Connecticut. The Honorable Richard Blumenthal, United States Senator, State of Connecticut. Ladies and gentlemen, our ship sponsor, Mrs. Michelle Obama, First Lady of the United States, escorted by Master Chief Petty Officer David DiPietro, Chief of the Boat. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Dan Malloy, Governor, State of Connecticut, escorted today by Commander Jesse Porter, USS Illinois' prospective commanding officer. Ladies and gentlemen, honors to the Honorable Dan Malloy, Governor, State of Connecticut. Platform, hand salute. Platform, ready to. Advance the colors. Platform, hand salute. Retire the colors. Platform, ready, two. We would like to thank the Navy Band Northeast and Saluting Battery and the Silver Dolphins Color Guard for their participation in our ceremony today. Ladies and gentlemen, Chaplain Passmore will deliver the invocation.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we come with honor and thanks to you this day for life and freedom that has been willingly bestowed upon us by your gracious hand. It is for the protection of that freedom that we celebrate this grand and historic day for the Illinois, its crew, the plank owners, the Navy, and ultimately our nation. May her travels be many, her missions successful, and those who serve her always be diligent in times of crisis and times of peace. As we now give recognition to our honored traditions, let us not forget those standing the watch on the front lines in the war on terror, to seek your protection for them and to achieve the worthy objective of peace in our world. Eternal One, bless our proceedings and all who share in this joyous occasion today, and may we commit ourselves to you and your will and recognize your sovereignty over the affairs of all people in the often uncertain days in which we live. For we ask this in your holy and worthy name. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Passmore. Will the guests please be seated? Ship's company, parade, rest. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Dan Malloy, Governor, State of Connecticut.
Thank you. Good morning. It is indeed my great pleasure to welcome all of the official party and all of you to this great ceremony. I particularly want to welcome our First Lady of the United States, Michelle Obama, to the submarine capital of the world, as we're known. What a great way to celebrate our 100th year as the submarine base for the Navy. I also want to take just one moment as I look over here and see Mr. Lincoln, to remind everyone of the connections between our state, Connecticut, and Illinois. It was Lincoln who appointed Gideon Welles as his Secretary of the Navy. During the time of the Civil War, Gideon Welles, along with the Navy, was responsible for growing the Navy tenfold. We were proud to see much of that construction here in Connecticut. It is fitting that the Illinois is now turned over to the Navy as an official ship, fully staffed in this 100th year of our existence as the submarine capital of the world. Let me also say that we are proud of the men and women who serve on this ship and all ships, as we are proud of the men and women who build these ships in our state. We are blessed as a nation to have a great Navy, defending our beliefs across the world. This platform, a preferred platform for the Navy for many different uses, is vital in the defense of our nation and the gathering of intelligence as well. So once again, let me say to all responsible, we appreciate the great and hearty work done to get this ship ready, and we appreciate being a home of the Navy. And we particularly appreciate having the First Lady, who has been at the laying of the keel, been at the christening of this ship, when the ship, I understand, fought back, and now this day, as it is turned over. God bless you, and God bless the United States of America.
Thank you, Governor Malloy. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Matthew Mulherin, Corporate Vice President, Huntington Ingalls Industry, and President, Newport News Shipbuilding.
Good morning, distinguished platform guests, ladies and gentlemen, and most especially Illinois sponsor, First Lady Michelle Obama. I am privileged to be here representing the 20,000 women and men of Newport News Shipbuilding, shipbuilders who come to work each day to do their best and to be their best, whether working on a submarine, in a shop, or at a desk. Being a shipbuilder isn't just what we do, it's who we are. One of our shipbuilders is Sharonda Steverson, who buys material and equipment for Virginia-class submarines. She sums it up best when describing what it's like to work at the shipyard. She says, it's a place where you're made. For many shipbuilders, including myself, this holds true. It's a place where we've grown up. It's a place that allows us to earn an honest living, raise a family, and make a difference. It's the place where we learn what the word quality really means. This submarine, USS Illinois, represents a commitment to quality by a team dedicated to continuous improvement, boat after boat, delivering each submarine ahead of schedule and under budget. Like her sister ships, USS Illinois is a technological marvel. She represents the very best of American manufacturing, innovation, and pride. She represents the very best of the U.S. Navy and Commander Porter and his fine crew. But this submarine has something, or maybe someone, that her sister ships do not have, and that is the First Lady of the United States. During the christening ceremony, Mrs. Obama imparted her strength, her sense of service, and her inspiring spirit into the submarine. And because of this, USS Illinois will always stand for freedom everywhere she sails, representing our nation's 21st state and the United States for many years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mulherin. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jeffrey Geiger, President, General Dynamics Electric Boat.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to recognize today's distinguished platform guests, especially the sponsor of Submarine Illinois, First Lady Michelle Obama. Thank you, Mrs. Obama, for being here. Mrs. Obama's close involvement with Illinois and its crew traces back to June of 2014, when she laid the ship's keel at an exciting ceremony at our Quonset Point, Rhode Island facility. I'll never forget when she began her remarks there with, wow, this is really cool. A little over a year ago, Mrs. Obama graced our Groton shipyard when she christened this submarine in a ceremony that was memorable and enjoyable. The officers and crew of Illinois couldn't hope for a more enthusiastic sponsor. It is my great pleasure to be here today representing the 14,500 women and men of General Dynamics Electric Boat. We are proud of the role we played in designing and building this 13th ship of the Virginia class, the newest and most capable submarine in the United States Navy fleet. Additionally, today's ceremony is an occasion of pride and fulfillment for our teammates at Newport News Shipbuilding, the United States Navy, the nationwide submarine supplier base, and our congressional supporters. Along with the rest of the Virginia class, this submarine is maintaining the Navy's undersea dominance for decades to come. We are grateful for the contributions of everyone who helped Illinois reach today's milestone. Together, we are working to ensure that the Virginia-class program produces the finest submarines the world has ever seen. Finally, and most importantly, I want to acknowledge the contributions of Commander Jesse Porter and his outstanding crew who have brought this ship to life. I had the privilege to participate in Illinois' first initial sea trials and was greatly impressed and inspired by the performance of the ship and its crew. What this crew was able to do, only a few hours after leaving the pier for the first time. Putting this ship through her paces was an awesome demonstration of individual and collective skills. Commander Porter, your crew's level of performance is a testament to their tireless dedication to duty and commitment to excellence. And I know I speak for everyone here today when I extend my best wishes to Commander Porter and his ship's company for a safe and distinguished tour of duty. May the USS Illinois serve you and our nation long and well. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Geiger. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Joseph Courtney, United States Representative, 2nd District, State of Connecticut.
Thank you, XO. First, I'd like to thank Captain Paul Whitescarver of the Groton Submarine Base for hosting another successful commissioning at the submarine capital of the world, a center of excellence combining the Navy's 100-year-old base and Electric Boat's nearly 120-year history of building the most complex and capable warships on the planet. Governor Malloy's presence here today underscores the commitment of our state to the thousands of sailors, officers, and civilians who work here every day, as does Senator Blumenthal. Under Secretary Davidson and CNO Admiral Richardson, it's great to have you here highlighting the Illinois' importance to our Navy. Welcome to all our guests from Illinois who made the trip to be here today, and you threw a great party last night. Commissioning a new submarine is always a special occasion, but today's event is particularly significant for two reasons. First, we are so honored to have the First Lady of the United States, Michelle Obama, as the sponsor of the USS Illinois. Having been to the Keel Lang, christening, and now today's event, I have seen firsthand her graceful and sincere focus on Commander Porter, the crew, and most of all, their families. As sponsor of the boat, she technically will be part of the ship's crew for its entire 30-year service, and thus will be a lasting part of the ship's history as it does great things in the service of our nation. What a lucky omen for this boat and its crew. Second, USS Illinois is part of a key unfolding story of growth and opportunity here in southern New England. In 2007, Congress passed the law increasing Virginia submarine production from one a year to two, reversing the years of stagnant investment in our undersea fleet. The Illinois, along with the USS Washington, to be commissioned early next year, represent the first submarines to result from the increased build rate, marking the first year since the 1980s that our nation bought more than one submarine in a single year. The impact of that milestone can be seen across this region, from having five submarines under construction at the same time inside the EB shipyard, hundreds of openings for new trades and engineering jobs, and the growth of small business suppliers to the submarine program. As President and Mrs. Obama's time in the White House draws to an end, it is worth noting that this submarine, our shipyard, this base, and this entire region have been part of an under-recognized legacy of President Obama and Navy Secretary Ray Mabus. Together, working with Congress, they doubled the number of ships under contract in the last 8 years, 85 versus 41, stopping a decline in the fleet and putting us on a path towards a 305-ship Navy. As a congressman who represents this district and the ranking member of the Sea Power Subcommittee, I want to publicly thank President Obama in the presence of the First Lady for making such a big, positive difference to our Navy and to this region. Commander Porter, congratulations to you and your hardworking crew for getting this submarine ready to serve our nation. When the crew of the Illinois brings the boat to life, casts all the lines, there will be no turning back. But we all know that you're ready to perform at the highest level. We thank you for your service and all you will continue to do to protect our country under the seas. Thank you all again for being here today.
Thank you, Representative Courtney. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Richard Blumenthal, United States Senator, State of Connecticut.
Thank you so much. How proud I am to be back here for another commissioning and another event at the site of the largest shipbuilding program in the history of the United States of America. And I want to join with my colleague as a member of the Senate Armed Services Committee in thanking President Obama for his dedication and diligence in making this day possible and the 13th of the fast attack Virginia-class submarines. And welcome to the First Lady, and to all who are here today, most especially to our veterans. If I can just ask all of the veterans who are here today to please raise your hand so we can thank you and salute you for your service to our nation. Thank you. Madam First Lady, as you probably know, the sponsor of this boat is an honorary member of the crew. And I am sure there are days when you wish you could disappear, even briefly, below the sea. But we are very proud to have you here today. And Jeff, if I could just correct one slight omission in your quote. When she was here, or actually at Quonset Point, for the keel laying, the First Lady said, and I quote, "All right, can I just break with protocol and say, this is really cool?" Well, if I may break with protocol, Madam First Lady, and say, you are really cool. Thank you. We are here really to celebrate a technological wonder that will help keep us safe and safeguard our freedom. And as amazing as this boat is, brimming with technology, equally amazing are the men and women who make the boat and build it. The engineers and designers, the pipe fitters and electricians, the welders, and all who come to work every day through the gates of Electric Boat just down the river, and who work tirelessly and tenaciously with zero tolerance for error. We know that we will have the finest and ablest men and women at sea on this boat, built by the best and skilled working force in the United States of America who work at Electric Boat every day, and we thank them for the great work that they do. Let us celebrate them as we do our men and women in uniform, because they are equally important to our nation's defense. Our United States Navy keeps the peace and safeguards our freedom, and the safety of our seas is essential to trade and to freedoms of people around the world as we project force there. And it is essential to trade that aids our economy and creates jobs. So all of us can be thankful for the strength of our United States Navy and say thank you today to the men and women who will take this boat to sea, make us proud. Thank you to them, and God bless our great country. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Blumenthal. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Janine Davidson, Undersecretary of the Navy.
Good morning. Governor Malloy, members of Congress, CNO Richardson, distinguished guests and flag officers, and especially the First Lady, Michelle Obama, good morning. I am absolutely delighted and honored to be here today because, yeah, this is really cool. This is about the coolest thing I get to do in my job. When the newest, quietest, most capable, and most deadly submarine in the U.S. Navy is being named after the state known as the Land of Lincoln, I am reminded of a quote from our esteemed 16th president, which strikes me as particularly appropriate for this occasion. "The dogmas of the quiet past are inadequate to the stormy present. We must think anew and act anew." Indeed, into this stormy present, we find ourselves contested in many different ways, in many different places across the globe. Some are hot conflicts, yet most are less combative and counterintuitively may have more at stake, strategically speaking. In such an environment, President Lincoln is absolutely correct. We must indeed think anew. Now, I have visited with and conversed with our fleet commanders, and I'm confident that they are well engaged in this endeavor and certainly do think in new, creative, and even nonlinear ways. In such an environment, we must also act anew. The USS Illinois is the most capable instrument on the planet, our nation's preeminent strategic asset. With stealth, mobility, endurance, and firepower in abundance, the beauty of such an instrument is that she allows us to act decisively through sea control, maritime security, presence, and deterrence. We must utilize her and her steadfast crew with purpose and wisdom in order to calm the storm of which Lincoln spoke. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Secretary of the Navy Ray Mabus, I wish to thank those who designed, built, and launched this great boat. It is a product of the persistent and committed partnership between the U.S. Navy, Electric Boat, and Newport News Shipbuilding, a partnership which is tried and tested, complex beyond measure, yet refined to an art form which can only really be best described as a modern engineering marvel. All due credit goes to this team for delivering this boat ahead of schedule and, yes, within budget, very rare metric these days. Well done. I wish also to thank First Lady Michelle Obama, the sponsor of the USS Illinois. The all-important role of sponsor is to bestow good luck and divine protection over the vessel and all who sail aboard her, as well as to imbue it with her personality. This process started with the keel laying in June of 2014 and then during the christening in October of 2015. She breathed life into the hulk and became, as it became a ship, an entity with a soul, as our sailors like to say. Now at its commissioning, the boat is ready to join the fleet, to test its legs, to become a United States ship, and to begin its long and strategically important life in the service of this nation. First Lady Michelle Obama, this boat and her crew are so lucky to have you as their sponsor. Thank you for your dedication to all the men and women who wear the cloth of this nation, and to the families who also serve. For Commander Porter, congratulations to you and your assignment as the first commanding officer. Good luck to you, your officers, and your crew in the days and years ahead. May they be as challenging as well as rewarding to you as you protect this nation from all enemies. Once again, from Lincoln, beware of rashness, but with energy and sleepless vigilance, go forward to give us victories. To all our present here today, be humbled and privileged to have been a part of this momentous occasion. May God bless the USS Illinois, her crew, her sponsor, and may God bless America. I'm not finished. And now it is my great honor and pleasure to introduce my friend, my colleague, and a fantastic Chief of Naval Operations, John Richardson, to give our promising first remarks.
Well, good morning, everybody. It is so terrific to be back here in Groton, my second home. All of our submariners call this our second home. And I would say that if you are in any way consider yourself a naval person, a person interested in national security, this is the place to be right now here in Groton. This is the spot. Mrs. Obama, thank you so much for making time to come out, taking time out of your busy schedule. Just another indication of the dedication, authentic attachment you have to this boat and her crew. Governor Malloy, thank you so much for doing everything to host us here. Your strong support for all of the Navy, and particularly the base here in Groton, undeniable. You just have to look around and see everything that's been done, visible manifestations of the strong support you have. Thank you, sir. Congressman, Senator Blumenthal, Congressman Courtney, this would not be possible without you and the support of Congress, this team that brings this whole boat together. So thank you for your strong support. Undersecretary Davidson, thank you for those stirring remarks and for that terrific introduction. leaders in industry. Could I have all the shipbuilders raise your hand, please, if you're a shipbuilder? Let's give them a rousing round of applause. I will tell you that I get a chance often to go to see our shipbuilders around the country, particularly those nuclear shipbuilders that build our submarines here in New England and at Quonset Point and here in Groton, also down in Hampton Roads at Newport News. I truly wish that I could bring every American through those shipyards to see the amazing things that this country can do when it puts its mind to it. It is as patriotic and as inspiring as anything you could do. And we would not be here without those tremendous shipyards, which, as you've heard, build this vessel, you know, thousands of tons down to precision that is measured in thousands of inches. It is really, really remarkable. So to all of us, veterans have been, Senator Blumenthal recognized you. Let's give another round of applause to our veterans, particularly our submarine veterans. Sub-vets, can you raise your hands? There you go. A lot of our submarine veterans here, thank you so much for all of your support and your service. And most importantly, to this team right over here, looking sharp, at parade rest, the crew of the USS Illinois, do they look ready or what? They have been waiting so long for this day to happen, working closely with that team of shipbuilders, other parts of the Navy, with our Congress, with everybody involved with bringing us to this day. Nobody owns this day more than that crew, and we'll have more to say about that later on. And so I would say, I propose that this is the place to be if you're in the Navy and interested in national security this day. But you don't have to take my word for it. When we want in the Navy, when we want to, you know, confirm that we're in the right place, we take a fix, right? We shoot three lines of bearing that tell us where we are. And so I'm going to just walk you through three lines of bearing that I think will bear me out and confirm that this is the place to be. First line of bearing cuts right through the historic and current significance of this town here in Connecticut, of Groton, Connecticut. The second line of bearing will cut through the state of Illinois and the historic and current significance and importance of the state of Illinois. And then finally, the third line of bearing through the strategic significance of the submarine force, and particularly the Virginia-class submarine, and particularly the newest Virginia-class submarine, the USS Illinois. So first line of bearing, Groton, Connecticut. It's so appropriate that we're conducting this ceremony here in Groton, the home of the U.S. submarine force, the submarine capital of the world. From David Bushnell, the inventor of the very first sort of submarine, the Turtle, the Revolutionary War, who was born just 25 miles west of here, to the Holland, delivered by the Electric Boat Company in 1900, all the way to the Nautilus, and today the Illinois. Groton has been the hub, the genesis of submarine innovation and warfighting tactics throughout our Navy's history. Electric Boat built the first nuclear submarine here 62 years ago. Imagine the difference between that boat, the USS Nautilus, and the submarine that we are commissioning here today. How fast we have learned about this incredibly complex mission set and the engineering challenges and talent that has risen to meet that mission. And as we stand here today in Groton, all of our submarine are second home at the confluence of the Thames and the Mystic Rivers near the sea. Business is picking up. It's a complex maritime environment that our Navy secures. Around the globe, our Navy, and soon this ship will join it, provides the foundation for American prosperity, enhancing maritime access, and maintaining our strategic influence in key areas around the world. So Groton, first line of bearing, cuts right to where we are. What about the USS Illinois and the state of Illinois, the land of Lincoln? And Illinois, while one may think it's far from the ocean, it is not far from the Navy. It has played a key role in our nation's maritime history, and we are honored to name SSN 786 after that state today. Perhaps most importantly, in Illinois is the quarter deck of the Navy. Naval Station Great Lakes, our only boot camp, is located there in Illinois. There, through those doors, we welcome 40,000 Navy recruits per year, take them from all around the country, and take them through that process of sailorization as they come into the Navy and become sailors. But I'll tell you, there's much more to it. Illinois has played a key role in the Navy throughout our history. Naval Ordnance Station Forest Park built more than 19,000 torpedoes for the Navy through World War II. And the Illinois Naval Militia, perhaps a forgotten but noteworthy effort, Civil War veterans and former Navy men drilled and trained in the early 1900s on Lake Michigan. They were tough, they were bold, and they were ready. And within 48 hours of the United States' entry into World War I, the entire Illinois Naval Militia had departed Chicago for the Philadelphia Navy Yard, and some were actually at sea within a week of the declaration of war, and they acquitted themselves with honor. Back home, back to where we are today, the first critical atomic pile became critical first underneath the stadium at the University of Chicago with Enrico Fermi, the first step that led to the super advanced reactor core that will power the USS Illinois, a core that will last for the entire life of the ship, 33 years, an engineering marvel. She will never need to pull in for gas. And to get a sense of how Illinois is so key to our Navy success, one only has to appreciate that more than 60 ships have been named for Illinois, its citizens, its counties, its cities, including two Nimitz-class aircraft carriers, the Lincoln and the Reagan. And 22 Navy servicemen from the state of Illinois have been awarded the Medal of Honor, including James Bond Stockdale, one of our most courageous naval leaders. So the second line of bearing crosses right where we are. Now, for everybody here, I'll have to beg your forgiveness because this third line of bearing involves, and I'm going to direct my remarks directly to the crew, the captain and his crew. It is the third line of bearing that brings us here, the crew of the Illinois, here to strike fear into the hearts of our nation's enemies and bring warm reassurance to our partners and friends. Team, there are many out there who have been waiting a long time to address you, not as a pre-commissioning unit, not as a construction project, but as a United States ship, the USS Illinois, a powerful warship. Our nation's leaders have been waiting. They've been waiting for you to join the fleet. Our frontline warfighters have been waiting. They've been waiting for the full range of options that you're going to provide, from covert surveillance in peacetime to decisive firepower in wartime in service to our nation. You will help us maintain our Navy's maritime superiority. Our allies and partners have been waiting because they know you'll be on patrol soon, from the cold, deep waters of the Arctic to the warm, shallower waters of the tropics. And they are reassured knowing that you're out there, a force for good, a force keeping the global economy flowing freely across oceanic trade routes. But while there are many who have been waiting for this day, waiting to address you as the USS Illinois, it is not everybody who has been hoping this day would come. There are those who would wish us harm. There are those who would oppress their people, deny them education, deny them freedom of religion and other freedoms, who would deny people freedom of the seas. Those who oppose our national interests and our calling to protect the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And for them, This is a day that will keep them awake at night, trembling in fear and in a cold sweat. Illinois is a ship that will haunt them in their dreams. So to those who wish to do harm in our world, Captain, soon they will feel your heat and the heat of your crew. To those who would deny freedom, their worst day will be when they appear in the crosshairs of the USS Navy and the USS Illinois. So these three lines of bearing cut to a perfect fix. This is the place to be if you are a Navy person, if you are interested in national security. Here on this pier is where we belong. And it's here on this pier that we have our ship sponsor. Mrs. Obama, you embody all of this spirit. You're a firm advocate for our military families, all our military families, not just the families of this crew, but thank you so much for what you do for all of our military families. You provide an embrace that will forever give the crew of this ship a sense of family, but make no spirit, you also have a fierce spirit that will crush injustice. And so, Captain, the time is now. Make your team ready. You're needed on station, and there's not a moment to lose. And I know your team is up to the challenge. You have toughened them for the fight. You will be a reassurance to our friends, a staunch defender of this great nation, and a nightmare to our enemies. And so with that, I thank you. I extend my warmest congratulations to the crew and captain of the USS Illinois. Thank you all for being here at the crossing of these three lines of bearing of history and place and service to our nation to celebrate the commissioning of this newest submarine. And in closing, I'd just like to ask all of you one small favor. At the end of this commissioning ceremony, and after the celebrations have died down, and as you put your head down tonight, I ask that you say a prayer for all of our sailors, soldiers, airmen, and Marines, and particularly this day, our submariners and the crew of the Illinois who are out there on watch around the world protecting our freedom. God bless the crew and the USS Illinois. God bless the United States Navy, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Admiral Richardson. Admiral, I would be honored if you'd now place Illinois in commission.
On behalf of the Secretary of the Navy and for the President of the United States, I hereby place United States ship Illinois in commission. May God bless and guide this warship and all who shall sail in her.
Thank you, Admiral Richardson. Executive Officer, hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant.
Aye, aye, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. I direct your attention to the boat as we hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant. Illinois, button, put. Quartermaster, hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, the colors and commissioning pennant are flying over USS Illinois.
Very well.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
I will now read my orders. From Chief of Naval Personnel to Commander Jesse Porter, United States Navy. Subject, Bureau of Naval Personnel Order Number 1612 of 14 February 2013. When directed, detach present duty and proceed to pre-commissioning unit Illinois. Report to Submarine Group 2 as commanding officer for duties in conjunction with fitting out. Upon commissioning of USS Illinois, report for duty as her commanding officer. Admiral Richardson, USS Illinois, is in commission and I am in command. Executive Officer, set the watch.
Aye, aye, sir. Officer of the deck, set the first watch.
Aye, aye, sir.
The officer of the deck is the commanding officer's direct representative and, while on watch, is responsible for the safety and smooth operation of the ship. The long glass is the traditional symbol of an officer of the deck's authority in a ship of the line. To assist in this tradition, Admiral Archie Clemens, United States Navy retired, will assist in setting the first watch by passing the long glass to our first officer of the deck, Lieutenant Tim Dutton, United States Navy, from Derry, New Hampshire. The petty officer of the watch is a petty officer first class David Berard from South Windham, Connecticut. The messenger of the watch is Seaman Stephen Faulkner from Largo, Florida. And the boatswain's mate is petty officer second class Robert Danner from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Set the watch on deck, section one.
All right. Sir,
the watch is set.
Very well. Captain, the watch is set.
Very well. We are delighted to have our sponsor, Mrs. Michelle Obama, with us today. Mrs. Obama christened Illinois on October 10th, 2015. Mrs. Obama, I would be honored if you would join me and give the order to man our ship and bring her to life.
Well, hello, everyone. Before I begin, your chief of the boat asked me to say one word, and he promised that you would know how to respond. So let me give this a try. Fighting!
Line eye.
It continues to be very cool. Let me just start by thanking Governor Malloy, Undersecretary Davidson, Admiral Richardson, the officers of the Illinois, Commander Porter and Master Chief DiPietro, and all our other outstanding Navy leaders, as well as Senator Blumenthal, Representatives Langevin, Courtney, and Hultgren, and of course, Jeff Geiger and Matt Mulherin. And of course, I wanna take a moment to just give a huge shout out to our military families, our amazing military spouses and partners. And since we've asked people to raise their hands, I just want to find out how many military kids are here with us today. Let's give our kids a round of applause. And I understand this crew has been pretty busy. Since the crew was stood up, there have been 32 babies born and three more on the way. So, way to go. Thank you for that. And one thing I just want to say to the military families, while you might not wear a uniform,
I know, we all know, the nation knows that you serve and sacrifice right alongside of your loved ones. And we are so grateful and proud of all of you for your service to this nation. Now, we're here today to commission the Navy's newest Virginia-class submarine, the USS Illinois. And I have to say that this moment is a little bittersweet for me because today marks our last event together, at least while I'm First Lady, the end of a journey that started more than 2 years ago. Back then, this boat was in four components spread over three states. Today, it's the most advanced ship in the Navy, a ship that's as complicated to operate as a space shuttle. A ship that can carry out any kind of critical mission from search and rescue to scientific research. And all of this is a great credit to Jeff and Matt and all of the hardworking folks at General Dynamics Electric Boat and Huntington Ingalls Industries and Newport News Shipbuilding. Again, let's give them all a round of applause. Thank you so much for your hard work and dedication. But Jeff and Matt will also be the first to tell you that it takes more than great materials to make a great ship. That's why today, in addition to commissioning the ship, we're also celebrating the outstanding sailors who serve on it. We already knew that you all had all the exceptional qualifications on paper, but then you went out in sea trials and showed that you're even better in practice. You didn't just deliver this boat on time, you also displayed the courage and knowledge to truly earn your dolphins. And today, every single one of you can do everything on this ship. You can fight a fire, you can stop a flood. You all earned a perfect score on your weapons test, and you passed your engineering certification on the very first try. That's my crew. Proud of you all. From your head cook, Petty Officer First Class Joe White, who I hear runs the best mess in the business. Let's take a moment to honor the food. To Petty Officer First Class Ryan Mock, whose team of engineers oversees a nuclear reactor filled with over 450 degree water, which sounds like something out of Star Trek. This whole ship is just amazingly complicated to me. It's just incredible what this crew can do. So you all are the very definition of excellence. And speaking of excellence, I actually have the pleasure of making a special announcement today in recognition of his outstanding service. Ryan Mock's officers have selected him as this ship's Sailor of the Year. So, congratulations to Ryan and to his family. We're proud of you. And that's really why Jill Biden and I started joining forces, because we are proud of all of you. I can't say it enough. Working with our military community has been the biggest honor of my life. This is a proud moment for me. We wanted to rally all of Americans to serve you as well as you serve this country every single day. And I am thrilled by everything that we've achieved together over the past 5 years to ensure that you and your families have the jobs you deserve, the benefits you've earned, and the honor and support of our nation, that you know that we love you. So today I want to end by once again telling you that I am beyond proud. Your Commander-in-Chief is also proud. Thank you for giving me the incredible privilege of being associated with you and your families and with the Illinois for the rest of my life. I will continue to keep you in my prayers every single day and keep you in my thoughts and know that you have a sponsor that cares deeply. And from this voyage until her last, may God bless and keep this ship and all who serve on her. And with that, it is my honor to give your very first order. Are we ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Officers and crew of the USS Illinois, man our ship and bring her to life.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the crew of the USS Illinois salute you. We are proud to serve in your great Navy. Ready, two. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Captain, the ship is manned and ready.
Very well. Admiral, to follow. USS Illinois is manned and ready and reports for duty.
Very well. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Admiral Richardson, request permission to break your flag.
Captain, break my flag.
Break your flag, sir. Executive Officer Black, break the flag of the Chief of Naval Operations.
Aye, aye, sir. Quartermaster, break the flag of the Chief of Naval Operations. Captain, the flag of the Chief of Naval Operations is flying over USS Illinois. Ladies and gentlemen, Commander Jesse Porter, United States Navy, Commanding Officer, USS Illinois.
Illinois, parade, rest. Governor Malloy, Mrs. Obama, Senators, Congressmen, Admiral Richardson, distinguished guests, friends and family of Illinois, thank you for traveling the great distances to be here. We are honored that you are with us today. Today is the commissioning ceremony of our ship, Illinois. Submarining is a team sport, and today could not have happened without the great effort and enthusiasm of numerous organizations. The Illinois Commissioning Committee has been a steadfast supporter of the crew through their effort in making today memorable and through their assistance over the last several years to both my Morale and Recreation Committee and the Illinois Family Readiness Group. Thank you. Clearly, the Illinois could not be here without both the great shipyards, Electric Boat, and Huntington Ingalls Newport News, and the fine craftsmen and engineers whom I've interacted with through the duration of this tour. Captains Gradsdock and Hayden, Commander Perella, Commander Walker, Soup Ship, Groton has enabled us to have everything we needed, when we needed, to get our job done. Thank you for your support. Taking a ship to sea for the very first time is a monumental undertaking, and we were able to leverage the experience of some of the best submariners out there. Commodore Waters and McGonigal and the staff at Submarine Squadron 4, as well as Captains Green and Gabriel at the TICOM representative's office, has set the bar high for us in our certification, and the Illinois crew members are better for it. Thank you. If you are the spouse of an Illinois crew member, please stand up. Speaking for my entire crew, you are our favorite hello and our hardest goodbye. While the crew is hard at work, on the ship, in shift work, on duty, underway, life continues at home. Whether we stayed late before coming home or didn't come home at all due to a last-minute schedule change, your love and support and willingness to take care of the business that counts enabled us to do what we do. Thank you for always being there, giving us the encouragement and the ability to defend our nation. Your love and support sustains us, and I cannot thank you enough. Since reporting in the summer of 2013, I've seen the Illinois go from parts on pallets and in packing crates to modules, and then finally to the fearsome warship you see before you today. While the equipment and technology is awesome, it is only an assembly of inanimate objects. It is the crew that brings the ship to life, animating every aspect of the ship. It's the crew that harnesses the technology, develops the plans, executes the missions that makes this the potent warship that it is. Over the past nearly 3.5 years, as the ship was built, the crew came together. Starting as a disparate group, coming from all over the world, they assembled here. And they have made me immensely proud. I've asked them to do some very, very difficult things, sometimes to the point where it was difficult for me to look them in the eye. They performed those, and they have never let me down. I am immensely proud of every one of them. The submarine force and this ship will sail out, and it'll conduct missions in all over the world, conducting covert strike, anti-submarine warfare, anti-surface warfare. These are things that the previous speakers have talked about, and I have a hard time matching what they said. But I can tell you that we are ready. They're important missions, but we must also be mindful that just the mere presence of Illinois and that of her sister ships are a bulwark against the wider spread of conflict. I tell my crew that submarines sow chaos and indecision into the minds of their adversary. The submarine force has not been fully unleashed since World War II, and this is a good thing. We have been used sparingly as the destructive force inherent in these ships is immense. Just as in World War II, submarines today inspire a sense of dread that is pretty much universal. It is because our country's continued commitment to building and manning submarines like Illinois that our adversaries around the globe see our resolve in maintaining our way of life and freedom everywhere. It is because of the men and women who stand watch around the globe in each branch of the armed service that our country remains secure. Ladies and gentlemen, the Illinois has joined the fleet. The crew of Illinois has assumed our watch, a watch that will continue for the next 33 years, always waiting for the call and always ready. Thank you for making this a very special day.
Ship's company, a tin hut. Will the guests please rise? Chaplain Passmore will deliver the benediction.
Let us pray. Now, Almighty God, we lift up to you the USS Illinois. May those who serve this ship now and in the future be equal to the standards set by those who have come before them. In times of war, may they be heroic. In times of peace, may they be generous and supportive of others. In times of peril, may they be courageous. May her missions be successful, her troubled waters few, and may those whose hands have built her and a nation who supports her look upon this vessel with pride as she executes her tasks with excellence, stands the watch with diligence, and assists the less fortunate in our world as a beacon of survival, hope, and compassion. Almighty One, bless this vessel of freedom with honor, so that the light of peace and righteousness may one day triumph in your world. Let all who serve this ship say with that bright sailor's gleam in their eyes, I served on the USS Illinois, when they reminisce about the greatest achievements and proudest moments in their lives. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Passmore. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated and remain seated until our platform guests have departed.